Lou. You know tonight's the night of our premiere. Abbott and Costello go to Mars.
Look at the way you're dressed.
We've got to go down to the theater. The theater! We've got to go down there, Lou.
Oh, we do?
You know, all the heads of the departments are going to be there. All the heads of Universal International. All the heads of the National Broadcasting Company. All the heads of Malapete Company are going to be there.
Oh, Malapete?
They're all going to be there. All the heads.
Oh, all the heads?
Sure.
No bodies?
Oh, no. Give me a minute. You can't go dressed like that.
What are you worried about, Abbott? You look immaculate.
Well, come
and
on.
And I'm going to show you some class tonight.
Well,
I'm going to that premiere with you.
Well, that's swell.
I wouldn't worry about a thing, Abbott.
It's going to take time.
It ain't going to take too much time, Abbott.
What do you mean?
I'm going to get to that premiere right with you. Now, hold it right there. Take the robe off, Abbott.
Yeah,
right. Come on, you've got it, Abbott. Now, take it easy, kid. Take it easy now, Abbott.
What are you doing?
Now, hold it. Wait a minute. I'm ready.
Now, I'll tell you another thing.
What?
The National Broadcasting Company and Palmer and Peter complaining about everything that you're breaking every week.
They are?
Let's make one show without breaking a thing. What do you say?
I got something to tell you, Abbott.
Oh, now, Lou, come on.
They have hit me with everything but the kitchen sink.
Well, I am not going to disappoint you tonight. Okay?
The Colgate Comedy Hour, starring Abbott and Costello, with their guests, Hoagy Carmichael, Teresa Brewer, and the Amen Brothers.
Sorry, we're all sold out.
I beg your pardon, sir, but we are Abbott and Costello.
Abbott and Costello? If you're actors, use the stage door. That's the way you're supposed to go in.
Hey. I'll punch you right in the nose.
Who said that?
He did?
I don't.
You're going to punch me in the nose like this? What do you think, Joe? I'm going to job you. What are you...
Well, we're off, folks. We're off. We're off. Hey, take it easy. Come here. You ain't seen nothing yet. We're off. Hey, you big boy.
Yes.
I'll sue you for assault and battery.
How are you going to prove it? You have no witness?
I'll get a witness. Hold my partner. Hey, you. Hey, would you like to be a witness to something?
I want to be a witness. I want to be a friendly one.
Well, all right, you be a witness to this. I'd like to see you push him around again.
It'll be a pleasure.
Okay?
So you want to get pushed around again, do you?
Hey, did you see it? Who I'm going to do to you?
No, what are you going to do?
Nothing at all, but I'm going to pick my partner up. How do you feel, buddy boy?
What's happening?
Show ain't over yet.
Wait a minute, what's happening?
Come here, hold him again, will you, partner? I'll get another witness. Hold him again. Say, friends.
Yes.
You got a camera?
Yes.
Would you do me a favor?
Of course.
Would you take a picture of this big guy beating my partner?
Be glad to.
Would you?
Yeah.
I'd like to see you do it again.
Certainly, I'm beginning to like this. You want to
hold it, hold it. How was the light for you?
Oh, fine.
Go ahead, let him go.
You want a picture?
Have one. I got it. Did you get it?
Yes, a wonderful picture.
Good.
Now, to whom shall I send the print?
You sent it to Abbott and Costello.
Abbott and Costello?
Yeah.
The same Abbott and Costello who were on television?
Yeah.
So you're the guys who caused my kids to run around beating each other over the head with baseball bats, huh? Knocking themselves around and breaking up my furniture. Throwing each other through doors and windows. On account of you, hoodlums, I haven't got a decent chair in my house. I haven't got one whole pane of glass. I haven't got a door I can walk through. Why don't you get wise to yourself, you congenital idiot? Come on, Helen.
Just a minute. How about the picture?
You can have the whole camera.
Hey, Frank. What's the matter, buddy?
I don't think we're doing so good, kid. Come here.
Right.
Okay? May we speak to you for a minute, please?
Why, certainly.
You all set? The old rinky dink.
Hey,
come here. How was that war in 1919?
Telegraph for who?
Lou Costello.
Oh, you mind if I deliver it?
No,
here,
sir.
I'll switch your hats.
What is it?
I got a telegram here.
Who's it for?
For me.
Get out of here!
Hey, Mike.
Yeah.
You can take your 15-minute rest period now.
All right, just remember the theater's full. Let no one in it any time.
I won't let a soul in here at any time, Mike.
That's right.
This is the funniest Abbott and Costello picture we ever had in this theater.
Hey!
What?
Just wait a minute. I hear there's a fire around here.
A fire?
Yeah, where? I think I made it.
The sensational Amen Brothers. Thank you. now, Miss Music herself, Teresa Brewer.
While dancing with someone and longing for you, I saw you, my darling, with somebody new. And over his shoulder, I watched you dance by. The smile on your lips brought a tear to my eye. The music stopped playing, but you couldn't see that my eyes were saying, change partners with me. You looked oh so happy, but you never knew I was dancing with someone and longing for you. Till I was again with you. Let no other hold your charm. If my dreams could all come true, you'll be waiting for my arms. Till I kiss you once again, keep my love locked in your heart. Darling, I'll return and then we will never have to part. Though it may break your heart and mine, the minute when it's time to go, remember, dear, each word divine that meant again with you, just the way we are tonight. I will keep my promise true, for you are my guiding light, my life, my life. I will keep my promise true till I walk again.
Thank you.
didn't get in to see the premiere of the picture called Mars.
Lou,
but you saw it, didn't you?
Lou, it was out of this world.
How was the audience?
Funny. The picture was so funny, even I laughed at it, Lou.
Did you really?
But you know the highlights of the picture?
No.
The funniest part of the picture, Lou, was when I hit you like this. You'd be surprised how that audience yelled and screamed. They died laughing, Lou.
They laughed at that?
Oh, that was the highlight.
How about when the rocket ship went through the tunnel?
Oh, that was funny. That was funny. But not half as funny as the time I slapped you like that. Oh, they died laughing. That was really funny, Lou.
How about the time you was way up on the top of the truck on top of the box?
Oh, yes.
And I pulled the bottom box. And everything went down
and
fell.
Oh, yeah, yes, yes.
You laughed?
That was funny.
I thought that was funny.
not as funny as when I slapped it like that. That was really funny.
That was the funny part?
Oh, that was a real funny part.
I'm getting killed.
You want to explain the premiere?
Yeah, but I don't... Let's sit down.
All right, Lou, we'll sit down and have a sandwich.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
Go on, eat over at the other table.
So you want me to eat with you?
No, you're not going to eat over here. Go on, get out of here. Try to treat you nice, you don't want it.
You want me to sit by myself?
Sit by yourself.
You don't like me anymore?
I don't like you anymore. You want me to explain the picture to you, and I did.
You ain't going to have nobody else to slap my
head. Oh, go ahead. No. Don't do that to me.
I didn't even get in to see the picture.
Well, I'm trying to explain the picture to you. Go ahead, have a good time by yourself.
Hey, Abbott.
Do my what?
Did you ever see me pull the tablecloth from under all the stuff?
No, you don't.
I can do it.
No, you don't, Lou.
I can do it.
I say don't do it.
I can do it.
I say don't do it.
I can do it.
Louie.
It's a good one.
Louie, I'm telling you, don't do it. I want to show you the funniest part of the picture.
Oh, no.
I want to show
you. I didn't know it was going to go that.
I want to show you the funniest part.
I didn't know it was going to go that fast.
What do you have?
We'll have another table over there.
We'll have two hamburgers.
Two hamburgers.
I didn't think it was going to go that fast.
That's the way it went. Heads up.
Please, take them. My life is in danger. If I'm caught with this, they won't kill me.
Huh?
Bring it to the Cafe Amour at midnight.
What time?
At midnight.
There's daylight savings, you know, just went in.
Midnight.
Not five after, huh?
At midnight.
What a day. What a day.
We'll have it there.
All right. We'll remember, darling, at midnight.
Okay, darling, at midnight.
Hey, come on. Give me what she gave you.
At midnight.
Hey, Lou, a diamond necklace. We can hock this and...
Real diamonds?
Real diamonds. We can hock this and live all year. All year.
Hey, you fellas, did you see anything of a girl that went by here? She just stole a diamond necklace. If anyone caught with it, it's going to get a lot of time in a big house. I'll tell you what. I'm from a 23rd precinct, and my name is Brannigan. Now, if you really think about it, I'm not going to get the tougher thing, you understand? There you are. And don't forget, get in touch with me at the 23rd precinct.
I sure will.
Righto.
Okay, goodbye. Big boy. I dropped it out of his pocket. Abbott, the guy dropped it out of his pocket.
What?
The necklace.
Get rid of it.
Flowers to your lady.
How do you do, lady?
Would you like some flowers
no,
to
madam.
Your lady?
Who madam. Has a lady?
We
I
have no lady. We have no flowers. We have no water. We have no money, lady. What can we do?
But I haven't made a sale today.
I'm
Are you
sorry.
Sure?
We're very sorry, lady. We ain't got a buck to our name.
No.
Oh, you poor boy.
So true.
I'll tell you what. Take these. I'm sure they'll bring you good luck.
Yeah.
Get rid of that.
I got a minute.
Hey, Shorty, you see that jet? I just went by.
Okay, safe again.
You know you're going to jail for that?
I ain't going to go to no jail.
Oh, stolen.
Pardon me, sir. When you threw away the flowers, you also threw away the spot.
Oh, I did, huh?
Hey! What are we going to do with it?
I don't know.
Stick him up. Here, you can have it. You can have it.
Wait a minute, mister.
Hey.
Wait a minute. What are you going to do when that girl comes back and wants a necklace?
Oh, wait a minute.
What excuse are you going
to
have?
There's a girl. She gave me that necklace. She told me to meet her at the Casa Lamora or more or something. We get a spaghetti dinner for that.
Yeah.
At Casa Lamora. And she says, be there.
Yeah.
And if we ain't there with that stuff, she's liable to be mad.
Wait a minute.
So,
how can we prove that you were held up?
That's simple.
How?
Would you mind shooting a hole through my coat?
Good.
Why, sure. No. Wait till I get it off!
Now shoot it, you dope, you.
Say, that's a nicer looking coat than mine. You want to switch?
Well, okay. Now I got to switch coats with the guy.
Yeah.
Okay? Thanks, pal.
You're welcome, kid.
And my glad I got rid of that necklace, boy or boy. I was. Well, enjoy your hamburgers. What's the matter? Where's your hamburger?
I don't feel like a hamburger right now.
Hey, Abbott!
What?
Look at that weather out there. Isn't that awful weather? Well, let's see.
Wait a minute. Put that down. Yeah, the weather is bad out, isn't it?
Isn't it terrible?
Yeah. But it's good for that tree over there.
Abbott.
What?
Would you look over there, see if you can see the waitress?
You don't like that tree over there, do you?
You are not going to get me to look over there.
Well, let's eat up.
Still, see if you can see the waitress, would you please?
Good look at that tree, please.
I would be more than delighted.
Well, this.
I think so.
Well, here's luck.
Well, here's luck. Clunk.
Ha ha ha!
try yours now.
About that necklace. I said about the necklace.
Yes, yes.
I forgot to tell you that if you should find it, there's $1,000 reward for its return. Let me hear from you if you find it.
The necklace.
Huh?
Have you got the necklace? Is it in a safe place? Now give it to me. $1,000 sandwich?
Yeah.
You ate $1,000? Costello, listen, I've taken enough off you. That would have lasted me all winter. I needed that $1,000. You know how bad I needed that $1,000? Why did you go and give me like that, Lou? What was wrong? Why did you do it?
Could it be but Hoagy Carmichael?
Oh, buttermilk sky, I'm keeping my eyes peeled. What's a good word tonight? Are you gonna be mellow tonight? Oh, buttermilk sky, can't you see my little donkey and me? We're as happy as a Christmas tree, heading for the one I love. I'm going to pop her the question, that question. Do you, darling, do you do? It'll be easy, so easy, if I can only bank on you. Oh, buttermilk sky, I'm telling you why. Now you know, keep it in mind tonight. Keep a brushing those clouds from sight. Oh, buttermilk sky, don't you fail me when I'm needing you most. Hang a moon above a hitching post. Hitch me to the one I love. You can if you try. Don't you tell me no lies. Or will you be mellow and bright tonight? Oh, buttermilk sky. something like that, maybe I better do something else, huh? You know, most songwriters do a thing called a medley. You know what a medley is. Two or three bars from two or three song hits, if you have any hits. As soon as the composer plays the first two or three notes, you're supposed to recognize the song and give him a big hand. Then he'll eat you up with smiles because you recognize his song. Very corny. But sure fire. Think I'll do a medley. When I was in college, I had a tough time getting home-brewed beer until I found a grandma on the west side of town. She made it for me. She used to serve it to me in her kitchen. She had a rocking chair in the kitchen, and I used to rock back and forth and drink my home-brew, and that's where I got the idea for. Oh, rocking chairs got me. Just a big, yeah. My old rocking chair. Then a few years later, I wrote a song and dedicated it to my two grandmothers. They lived to be 94 and 96. Outlived me. Oh, I thought that was a good joke. You may remember a little old lady passing by. Catching everyone's eye. You have such a charming manner. Sweet and shy, little old bonnet set in place. And a smile on your face. You're a perfect picture in your lavender and lace. One day, a songwriter named Johnny Mercer came up to my apartment. He's from down in Georgia, deep south. He leaned up against the door. He said, Hoagie. And I said, huh? He said, let's write a song. We did write a song in about 20 minutes. Figuring as how we only made about $20,000 a piece out of it. Hardly worth our time. Lazy bones, even all the day. I expect to make a dime that way. You'll never make a dime that way. Looky here, he never heard a word I say. Then Johnny and I wrote a little song called In the Cool, Cool, Cool of the Evening. We said the bumblebee left, have a jungle boo. When said the prairie hen soon. Sure said the dinosaur, where said the grizzly bear under the light of the moon. But how about you, brother jackass? Everyone gaily cried. Are you coming to the fracas? And over his specs he sighed. In the cool, cool, cool of the evening. Tell him I'll be there. In the cool, cool, cool of the evening. You better save a chair. When the party's getting the glow on and singing fills the air. In the shank of the night, when the doings are right, you can tell them I'll be there. In the cool, cool, cool of the evening, tell them we'll be there. In the cool, cool, cool of the evening, they come on my hand.
When the party's getting the glow on, singing fills the air.
If there's gas in my hack or my laundry is back, you can tell them I'll be there.
Well, if I find the right spot,
if I can get out of bed and put a head on my head, you can tell them I'll be there.
Now, do you see the mess we're in? Or the mess you made outside of this restaurant? You like to break up the whole...
Exterior. Now, don't do it inside here. We'll be working here the rest of our lives.
What are you two stalling for? Get in that kitchen and get to work.
Yes, sir. Yes,
move!
Yes, sir.
Get something done.
Ah.
Good afternoon.
How do you do?
Won't you sit down? I'll have a waiter for you in just a moment. Costello! You idiot! Now, there's customers here. I want you to wait on them because I've got to go out. If you lose one patron, I'll break every bone in your head. Get going!
What can I do for you, please?
What would you recommend today?
The restaurant across the street.
We're going to eat here.
Go ahead and eat. Who's stopping you? Go ahead, order something.
Let me have a shrimp salad, chicken gumbo soup, cottage cheese with pineapple, grapefruit orange, half broiled chicken, filet mignon, medium rare, baked potato, cream peas, string beans, some corn on the cob, hot rolls, deep dish apple pie with cream. Now, what would you suggest to wash that down?
Pacific Ocean.
I'll have a vanilla malted and use your best grade of milk.
A vanilla malted? A vanilla malted you're going to get. Hey,
what do you want? See what it says there, out.
Yeah.
When you want to go in, you go in. When you want to come out, you go out. You don't win on the out. You go in on the in and not in on the out. You got to go out on the out and in on the in. When you want to go in, you go in. Don't come out on the in. Don't try to make move. When you go in on the in. You understand?
Let's do the baseball routine. Who's up first?
Stop it. I'll get your orders.
Okay. Girl wants some more milk.
Well, there it is underneath the counter.
I'm going to make it from here in.
I'd like to have two eggs.
Yes, sir. How do you want them?
Fry one on one side and fry one on the other.
Right.
Two eggs.
Yeah.
Fry one on one side and one on the other.
Right. Fry one on one side and one on the other?
That's right.
One side, one on the other.
Use two pins.
Yes. Oh, nice
short decision. Mm. Oh, fried. I'm over here right now.
Yucky.
Hey, I can't do that. Sweating?
What else you want?
Well, I'll have a salad, but salad. Make it here.
Right, sir.
I want to watch what I'm getting.
One salad.
One salad.
Salad, right?
Salad.
Salad, right?
Salad.
Right. Ready for the salad.
Right-o.
Hang on. Yes, Lou. For the season. Ching, chang, zoom. Chang. La-dee-la-dee.
Mix salad you want, don't you? Mix.
Yeah, you're going to get it. La-dee-la-dee.
Just a pinch.
Right, sir. How are the eggs?
Break an egg on top. Huh? Break an egg on top.
I hope that's our wardrobe. What are you laughing at up there?
My hands on that imbecile partner of yours, I'd give anything. I'd give $100.
You got it.
Oh!
Now I can't find the mark. Abbott told me to save $100 for a rainy day.
Thank you. Well.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Glad you've been a wonderful audience. I don't know. We break our neck for you, as long as you're nice.
Abbott, I think at this time we'd like to introduce a little girl that added so much class to this show.
It needed it, Lou.
Sure. A wonderful girl and the hit of the country at this time, Miss Teresa Brewer.
You're wonderful.
Pleasure having you with us.
And we hope someday to have you back.
Thank you so much,
Angela.
She's
great. Please be. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we'd like to have you meet the winner. Even now, the winner of all those wonderful hit tunes, Hoagy Carmichael.
Right now.
Oh, good to see you, Bud. Say, Hoagy, we understand you've got a show coming up very soon of your own.
Sure do. June the 6th on NBC. It's going to be called the Saturday Night Review. Yeah.
First two's going to listen. First two going to watch.
Well,
we'll be your guest,
too. I want you to be on it.
You got it.
Yeah,
we got
it.
Anything you got to break, send for us. We will. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, Abbott and I want to make just one little plea. We want all our friends all over the United States, please. There are hundreds of thousands of mentally retarded children, and they need your help.
This is all seriousness.
Bud and I would appreciate whatever help you can give.
Please send
whatever contributions you
any
can.
Any amount, friend.
Nickels, dime, anything.
Wait a minute. Look, we've got to think of the number.
M.R. Box 5670...
Chicago,
77, Illinois. And we'll bless you the rest of our lives.
Let's repeat that, Lou.
Give the kids a chance.
Box
5670, Chicago, 77, Illinois.
Please, whatever you can say.
Please.
You will certainly help those children.
Give them a break.
Do that for us, and God bless you.
Till next season, we love you.
The Colgate Comedy Hour has been presented by Halo.
Next week to listen to our friends, our pals, Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis.
The Colgate Palmolive Company invites you to watch Mr. and Mrs. North every week and The Big Payoff every day. Featured in tonight's cast were the Four Pipers, Sidney Fields, Michael Ross, Jack Lomas, Sherry Moreland, Evelyn DeSmith, Sid Marion, and Bobby Barber. Abbott and Costello can now be seen in the new Universal International picture. Abbott and Costello Go to Mars. Be sure and tune in again next...